So how many people in here live in Raleigh County? So not very many, just a few, right? Okay. How healthy do you think Raleigh County is? Pretty bored? In the middle-ish? So we're not doing very well whatsoever, actually. Got great resources of how to be healthy, but we're not doing very well. Okay? So some statistics. In 2015, this is all from a credible source. This is the latest statistics that I could find. For Raleigh County, the population is 138,361. Okay? Probably grown quite a bit since then, right? Okay? 51% are female, 49% are male, right? So good odds for a guy, right? For the most part. All right. Poverty rate, 18.1%. I would say that's probably increasing. For the ones that live here, work here, what do y'all think?
Yeah.
Probably. Okay. Median age is 40.3. What sort of things and problems do we see around that age time? What kind of health problems?
Cardiovascular.
What else?
Diabetes.
Respiratory problems, right? Okay. Anything else around the 40 age?
Menopause.
Yes, well, there's a greater population of female than male.
I think menopause at 40 is real.
All right. Median household income, $43,069. What do we think about that? That's pretty low, right?
Yeah. Wish I made that.
And let's look at our population, how much we have, and how many residents actually have jobs. That's pretty low. That's very low. So what do we see when we have a low number of people without jobs? Or a high number of people without jobs, excuse me.
Drug use.
Drug use is one, right? Okay. That's a big epidemic right now in Roanoke County, right? Okay. What about lack of insurance? What else?
Not necessarily eating properly.
Yep, not eating properly. That's good. That's great. So, you know, we've got some major problems that we see with what our population rate is compared to how many people actually have jobs. I was very shocked with this number when I was doing this research. It's very low. So, all right. So some more facts. Roanoke County is the 20th largest county in North Carolina, okay? I didn't really see that because, you know, I just picture Roanoke County as a very small county. But it's the 20th largest. We have 10 cities: China Grove, Cleveland, Bay, Spencer, East Spencer, Granite Quarry, Kannapolis, Landis, Rockville, and Salisbury, okay? And we know we've all got those little side towns as well, but these are the ones that they rank in. Okay, so we all talked about how we thought Roanoke County was pretty poorly rated, right? Roanoke County is technically ranked 73rd out of the 100 counties for healthiness. Okay, that's pretty low. That's actually very, very low. Okay, I don't know really much about the surrounding counties. Obviously, you know, this is generated off population as well. But pretty healthy. Pretty poor health-wise, correct? Would everybody agree with that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. 18% are adult smokers. We have 15% that excessively drink. 27% are alcohol-impaired driving-related deaths. Okay? Now, granted, this is 2015 statistics, okay? So that number is probably only increased, right? Hopefully it will decrease, but it's probably only increased because of what? Population growth, right? The number of adults, a number of dropouts, you know, adults getting to that age where they can start to legally drink as well, right? Granted, that doesn't really matter in this aspect because, you know, teenagers are getting alcohol. Okay. 33% adults are obese, obviously, since standing up here, example of that number. 29% are physically inactive, and 81% have access to exercise opportunities. What are some exercise opportunities that we have here in Roanoke County?
Planet Fitness.
The Forum.
The
Y. How many YMCAs do we have in Roanoke County?
Three.
Three, right? So, what's one thing? When do we see it starting to become deadly?
Okay.
What generation?
Geriatric.
Yeah, they're really, really older generation, right?
Okay.
And usually that's the ones that don't have the resources for the help. You know, they may not have resources as income or insurances that they can go to the doctor every time they start to get sick.
Or they could have been brought up. You know, a lot of them were brought up to where you could just go to the doctor and just check it out.
Exactly. You bring up a very good point. So she said, you know, a lot of geriatrics don't even go to the doctor because they were raised as into trying to do home treatment at first. Okay. All right, so the next one, which I figured would be number one, but it's not. It's number two, is congestive heart failure. Okay. Obviously, congestive heart failure is that condition in which the heart is inadequately pumping for the heart's demand. Okay. So what signs and symptoms do we see with CHF?
Swelling.
Swelling, right? That's usually like the very first sign, right? What else do we see? Or hear, or
fluid in the lungs
sound, right? They're usually pretty bad off when that starts happening, right? So what's our treatment for that? So CPAP for us, right? CPAP for us and EMS. Okay, but the biggest thing with people with CHF is that constant care that they get from their primary care cardiologist, right? Okay? But once again, with that medium income salary that we talked about earlier, can everybody go to the doctor every week? Can everybody go to the doctor every 2 weeks to try and help with this? A lot of this is, and a lot of the problem is too, is a lot of people can't afford their medications, correct? Okay. All right, and the third was MIs. Okay, so somebody kind of tell me what they know about MIs. Heart attacks. Has anybody had a relative that's been relatively affected by a heart attack? No.
Okay.
So, like you said, MIs, acute myocardial infarction, also known as a heart attack. Okay. And we know that that is where the heart has a lack of oxygen to the heart caused by some sort of a blockage that we can see down here in this picture. And it causes that heart muscle to die. Right? So, in EMS, where do we see that starting to come up as? What's the first sign and symptom that we see? Chest pain. And what do we see with the things that we have?
Elevation
in the EKG, right? Okay, so this is something that people don't really plan, right? Yeah, so they don't plan this. So there's not really a ton of things that they can do. Now, granted, they can do preventative maintenance. What can they do? Lifestyle changes, right? Quit smoking, quit drinking. Eat better, healthy diet, exercise, right? Okay. Now I will say to me personally, on my experiences, the worst heart attacks that I've had have been the healthy individuals. Now granted, there's no statistics to show that, but that's where I've seen the most, just in my experience. But it helps them have a better outcome, right? So some resources that are here in Rowan County specifically. There's a ton, and I didn't realize there was this many, okay? We have one bariatric surgeon, or surgery center, let me rephrase that, okay? It's right there next to the hospital. We have four ENT and allergy practices. We have 16 family medicines, one pediatric gastro, one heart and vascular center, which is attached to the hospital. Obviously, we have one hospital in Rowan County. Now, what are some other hospitals? We technically have three that are close by, right?
Northeast.
Technically, CMC Kannapolis, right? Mm-hmm. Okay. And we can also go to Baptist as well. That's not that far. Okay. One infectious disease, six internal medicines, one urology and sleep, four OBGYNs, one GYN and aesthetics, seven orthopedics, and one prenatal clinic, one general psychiatric, and one geriatric. Psychiatric centers. Is anybody shocked with these numbers or realize that we have this many resources in Rowan County? I was kind of shocked. I mean, I'll be honest. I didn't realize that we had this much. I figured with us being this close to Charlotte and Winston-Salem that, you know, we didn't have the resources. Okay? Other things that we have, these are the low to no cost. I knew of one, I did not realize of the other. We have community care clinic in Rowan County. near the hospital as well. They offer a primary medical care, adult dental care, and pharmacy to qualified undeserved and uninsured adults in Rowan County. This clinic is very, very busy. Very, very busy. The other one is Cabarrus Rowan Community Health Center. This is one that I didn't know about until I done the research. And that is the community health center provides primary care, preventive health services, and access to community resources for all populations. Okay? Once again, for the medically undeserved. So, these people that go to this probably, A, don't meet that median household salary, right? Or income that we talked about earlier. And they also probably don't have insurance as well, correct? So, we talk about these and, you know, you talk with the doctors. These doctors don't get paid. If they get paid anything, they don't get paid anything at all, okay? They're doing this to benefit Rowan County. So I feel like these are two great resources to the undeserved that we do have in Rowan County, okay? Some other no-cost resources that we have, we do have two shelters, we have crisis assistance providers, five food providers, one life coach providers, and two clothing providers, okay? But also, we can contribute to those as well, right? We can help us either volunteering or donating clothing as well. Some other medical resources that are here within Rowan County. We have one inpatient psychiatric center, two surgical practices, four urgent cares, one urology practice, one oncology center, 13 chiropractic centers, 43 dental practices. I had no idea there was 43 dentists in Rowan County. That's a lot. One dermatology practice. We've got two dialysis centers. Do we know where those are at?
Davita. Oh, one is on Staples Boulevard,
yep.
And the other one is in
Memphis. Yep, that's right. So South End and kind of West End, right? Of that. One emergency care center, obviously. Rowan ER. One in endocrinology center, two hearing specialists, 18 home health providers, which I did not realize we had that many home health providers as well, which is great. be great. You know, we can all get fresh vegetables that are from local farmers. Talk about three YMCA facilities and obviously the two other gyms that we have as well. One commercial fitness center, healthy eating instructions, nutritional programs, three retail nutrition centers. So we talk about PNC, Vitamin Shop, you know, we've got that organic health food store in downtown Salisbury. One senior center,